Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this week's Pod Racing Circuit Semi-Pro Baroo Coast course. We've never been on Baroo before. This is a very different course than usual. It's got both volcanoes and vines and beaches and retirement homes. Everyone loves to retire to this place, folks, because it is tropical, it is warm, and there is lava. Why that is a draw, I don't know why. Personally, I would prefer to not die a fiery, hideous death. But that is just my personal opinion. Welcome to the Baroo Coast. On this one, we are going to follow Elon Musk. The course favorite is, of course, Navakey. He's got that really tight, hard pod racer, but we are not watching him. We watched him already before, folks. Place your bets, get your truckets ready, and get your money ready, because we are about to begin. You can see that Elon Musk has a bit of a seashell pod race, and we are off to the races. We can see that the race starts in the city, in the old city of Baroo, and we can see that he is already smashing through. He is in fourth. This is a pretty good race, folks. I may have mentioned Elon Musk. It has not raced too terribly much in his career. Is just getting started. We can see that he's smashing into the sides, but he is trying, folks. He is trying so very hard. This is a very ancient city. We can see the old rope bridges. Oh, and he went off a cliff. He took the support cliff off, and he managed to get right up in there into third. He is right behind Bullseye Navoir, and he is catching up to Navakey, who, again, as I've said before, we've seen before. But you can see that these are very ancient pathways. They are made of stone, and they are on the beach. And he tried to go right. I'm not sure why he tried to go right. The course, of course, went left. And we can see those ancient heads. This is a very historical planet. It's been around for eons. Some of the eldest species in the galaxy come from this planet, folks. But we can see that he's already into the forest. We can see he's smashing into those things. Again, Navakey's pod racer is built for this kind of thing. And of course, we know that Bullseye Navoir is also a very good turner. We've watched him before. But Elon Musk's pod racer just quite can't make those curves. And oh, he found a shortcut, folks. The vines and the woods in Baroonda often give you it makes the course a little bit confusing and a little bit wobbly, but at least it works well for shortcuts. And we can see that he just took first. He managed to catch up to Navakey despite the fact that he cannot turn. But we can see that as the course is a bit more straighter, the curves are a little bit, but he lost the race again, folks. He's in second again, but he is very strong, folks, for having not raced very much. He is still coming on very, very strong. We can see Rats Tyrell right behind him, vying for that second place. We can see Sly Paramita, again, from an ice planet, up there, back there, trying to catch up to the top three back. Oh, but Elon Musk is having trouble as he comes into this ancient city. He has to repair, and as we all know, folks, repairing is death when it comes to pod racing. It's not as bad as actual death, of course, but it does slow you down. It lets other pod racers pass you, and it's just so much harder to catch up once you lose that ground. It's very tricky, folks, very tricky. This course, as you can see, it's because of all the jungle, because of the lava, because of all of this stuff, it's tricky to navigate, especially for a first-timer, never having raced the course before. I am still so impressed that the rope bridges are still up. Those things are ancient. They're about to collapse at any moment. You can see Elon Musk again. Oh, you can see right there, folks. You can see right there on the left that the rope bridge is falling down. I have heard rumors that we have lost pod racers down that, off of that bridge before. But so far, it seems like no one's quite gone off of it right now. And Elon Musk's back on the beach. You can see the sand. It doesn't really get. And again, folks, he went to the right. I don't know why. He's been on this lap before. You have to be quick on that. Folks, you have to learn the course quickly. You have to learn it. You have to internalize it. And you have to just take those turns as they come. But Elon Musk seems to not be able to get that beach turn. But we can see he's still in second. Navakey is just past the halfway point on this course. And he is just so far out in first. I'm not sure if anyone's going to be able to catch up to him, but we can see Sebulba is now in third. Ooh, we made fourth, third. Oh, and he's right behind him. Maybe we can see his jet engines do the little flame poofy thing that we've seen before. I'm pretty sure that by all rights, you're not supposed to explode the other pod racer's engines by fire, but then again, who's going to stop them? It's not like this is a very legal sport anyway. But who knows? Elon Musk, of course, is repairing again, because again, he's smashing into the stone walls, which, despite the fact that we are a very futuristically historic culture, we still can't get past stone hurting things if you hit them. And of course, oh, there's a pretty bird, folks. There's a pretty bird. A little side note, I enjoy bird watching. I enjoy pterodactyl watching, and that bird is huge. It's a little difficult to see it from this angle, but the wingspan is as big as some starships, folks. It is big and it only eats berries, which is problematic because its mouth is the size of a gourd. But so it has to eat so many berries that it tends to strip trees bare in minutes. But we can see, anyway, coming back to the race, we can see Elon Musk is coming in for the end of his second lap, and he is in, not good, folks, not good. He is in ninth, I think. I can't tell. Everyone is so clustered together, and he has to repair again, folks. He is going to lose that. He is now in 10th. Oh, and he crashed, folks. He is crashed. He is going down. Not good. He's losing ground rapidly. He is now in 11th, losing only to Arc Bumpy Roos, who was the track favorite for the next race, by the way. And so he is now in 12th. He is in dead last, folks. That first lap was a very good lap for him, and he just didn't come into the third lap well. That second lap really did him in. He can't take the turns. He can't get that traction. The sand just kicks it all up, and if you just get off on that, there's no hope for you after that, folks. There's no hope for you then. And here we are on the beach again, where he always... Oh, and he went left. It only took 3 times, but he learned the course. That is always a good thing. One must learn the course if one wishes to do well. I feel like I shouldn't have to say that. But we can see he is in 10th. He is holding on to 10th. Oh, my goodness, folks. He had been so high up in the front. We can see that Neva Key still has a lead. It's not nearly as strong as it was in the second lap or the first lap. Or no, he wasn't in first in the first lap. But we can see Bullseye and Rats are still vying for that second place, and they are tight. They are tight, tight, tight. But Sebulba is trying for fourth, and we can see Mars Goo is catching up to Sebulba. They are coming into the final stretch, folks. But back to Elon Musk, the seashell pod racer. He's in 10th, folks. He is holding on to 10th. Maybe he can get into 10th. I don't know, but he's in the tunnels. He is in the ancient tunnels, none of which have collapsed in over 20 years. So we are very impressed with the construction on that front. But he is taking these turns that, again, he cannot always do well with. And we can see that Neva Key has taken first. We can see Bullseye and Rats. That was a close call, but I think Bullseye managed to edge out Rats just at the very end. Here we can see Elon Musk is coming in for the final stretch. He is in 10th. We can see that they are Arc Bumpy Roos and someone else is right behind him. They're coming in for the final stretch. This is where Elon Musk crashed last time. The curves are tricky. He can't quite make the curves, and it's a final curve. We can see he's catching up. He's catching up to Mahonik, and he is coming in for the final. Folks, he managed to catch Mahonik for 9th. That is impressive. I am very impressed with our man Elon Musk. Good job, Elon. Hard-fought race. You did well in the first lap, but then you sort of petered out. This was the 6th out of 7 semi-pro pod racing circuits. We have one more to go, folks. One more, and then we will have the champion of the semi-pro circuit. The next one is on Aquilaris, which we've seen a couple of times before, with the track favorite Arc Bumpy Roos, who I think came in 12th in this one. So, let's hope he gets his button gear. So, I hope to see you all next week. Good night, and good luck. Yeah, look.